Let's apply impulse and momentum to this two-particle system. So particle M1 is coming towards M2. It's going to smash into it. M1, we're told, is greater than M2. So that whenever it smashes into M2, M2 is going to go flying off this way, and M1 is going to just sort of barrel through it and follow behind it. Okay? So let's apply impulse and momentum. But we've got two particles here, so we need to apply the sum of the momentum, the initial momentum, and then add the impulse term, and then that will be equal to the sum of the final momentum of each of the particles afterwards. So, and this, our initial equation, let's just write it down. P naught plus, and then we have that integral term, right? So we'll just represent it. Let's just go ahead and put it like this. But for the non-calculus people, don't sweat it. This is just, remember, this is F average times delta T, right? From T0 to T final, which we'll leave off for brevity. And this is equal to P final. Okay. But we have two particles. So we need to take into account the sum, right? So let's say the sum of the initial momentum, sigma P0, like this, plus this term here, this is the external forces acting on the system. So if we wanted to, we could say this. We could say that this is the sum of the external momentum acting on the two particles, like this. We're going to see in a moment that that goes away. And that's equal to sigma P final, like this. But only external forces can add momentum to a system. And so these two particles are interacting with one another, and so those are internal forces. And so this term is going to go away. Okay? So we see this is the infamous conservation of momentum. Sigma P0 is equal to sigma P final. And this will be a powerful result that we can use to solve for the velocities of objects, you know, things banging into one another. Because all those forces of things, those things that are interacting with one another, those are internal forces. Those are not forces from outside, like a rocket ship, you know, pushing on a ball or something. If only the two balls are interacting with one another, then this is true. See you next time.